Hello, welcome again. We are solving GATE 2020 Mechanical Engineering Paper 1, question number 50. Air discharges steadily through a horizontal nozzle and impinges on a stationary vertical plate as shown in figure. So this is the inlet pressure 0.66 kPa and this is the first pressure, this is plate and this point is 0. The inlet and outlet areas of nozzle are 0.1 meter square and 0.02 meter square respectively. Take air density as constant and equal to 1.2 kg per meter cube. If the inlet gauge pressure is 0.36 kPa and the gauge pressure at 0.0, this point is 0, on the plate is dash kPa. Okay. So round off to 2 decimeters. So this is your gauge pressure, okay, not the actual pressure. So applying Bernoulli's equation, applying Bernoulli's equation at 11922. Okay. So P1 is your 0.36. So as this is gauge pressure, so we, and this is atmospheric pressure, so we'll take it at 0. So P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus Z1 is equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2. Z1 and Z2 are same because it is horizontal nozzle. So P1 is your 0.36 into 10 to the power 3 Pascal and P2 is your 0. Okay. So and V1 velocity, V1 is the velocity at 1 and V2 is the velocity at 2. Okay. So and rho is given as 1.2. Okay. Density is given as 1.2. So from this we can calculate V1, V2 square minus V1 square, that is 600. Okay. Now from continuity equation we can get applying the equation at 11922, A1 V1 equal to E2 V2. So A1 V1 is equal to E2 V2. So A1 is your A1 is your 0.1 and A2 is your 0.02. Okay. So putting the values A1 and A2, we can find out ratio V2 by V1, that is 5. So this is the difference, this is the ratio. So we can find out V1 and V2. Okay, so by putting V2 by V1 as 5, here we can find out V1. Okay, so V1 is your 5 meter per second. Okay, and pressure at this 1 is your 0.36 and velocity 5 meter per second. Okay, so this is the total total pressure of the system is that pressure plus dynamic, static pressure plus dynamic pressure. So static pressure is 0.36 into 10 to the power 3 Pascal and dynamic pressure is rho u, rho v, 1 square by 2. Okay. So because here the velocity is V1 and pressure is P1. So only the two types of pressure, that is static and dynamic pressure, is there. And that pressure, that depends on what kind of energy. So energy will remain constant up to this. Okay. So the total pressure or total pressure, because at this point when it strikes the plate, the velocity becomes 0. So the whole of the pressure will be static pressure at this point. So magnetic pressure, so dynamic pressure also changes into static pressure. So total pressure is 0.36 into 100,000 plus 1.25 square by 2. That is 3075 Pascal or 0.375 kilopascal. So answer is 0.375 kilopascal. Okay. Next, 51. Air enters a perfectly insulated compressor at a temperature 300 Kelvin. The pressure ratio of the compressor is 6. Specific heat at pressure of air is 1005 joules per kilogram per degree Kelvin. The ratio of specific heat at constant pressure and constant volume is 1.4. Assume the specific heats of air are constant. If the isentropic efficiency of the compressor is 85%, the difference in enthalpy between the exit and inlet of compressor is dash kilojoules, round off to 2 decimal places. Okay. So this is 0.1, this is 0.2, and 1 and 2 are corresponding to isentropic process and 1 and 2 dash are corresponding to real process of the compressor. Okay. Now the pressure ratio is given as 6, okay, and initial temperature is given as 310. We can find out this T2 by using isentropic relationship. So T2 by T1 is equal to Rp gamma minus 1 by gamma. Gamma is 1.4. So from this we can get T1 is 310. So from this we can get T2 P2 is 517.22 Kelvin. So this is 517.22 Kelvin. Okay. And now the isentropic efficiency is 0.85. That is here. Okay. So we have now T1 and we have now T2. So isentropic efficiency of the compressor is nothing but T1 minus T2 minus T1 divided by T2 dash minus T2 T1. Okay, that is isentropy of compressor. So from this we can get T2 dash minus T1. Okay, so that is 517.22 minus 310 divided by 0.85. So that is T2 dash minus T1 is 243.788 Kelvin. Okay, now the change in enthalpy is here, nothing but Cp T2 dash minus T1. So that is 245.07 kilojoule per kilogram. Okay. Next, 1 kilogram of air initially at temperature of 127 degrees Celsius expands reversibly at a constant pressure until the volume is doubled. If the gas constant of the air is 287 joule per kilogram per degree Kelvin, the value of mass transfer is dash kilojoule round of 2 to the same degree. Now initial temperature is 127 degrees Celsius or 400 Kelvin. Let initial volume be V, and as it is, as during the process the volume is doubled. Okay, so final volume is 2V. Okay, so then and the pressure, the process is constant pressure. So using the state relationship, we have this, we can find out this temperature T2 also. Okay, we are putting, sorry, P, now P1 V1, V1 is equal to P2 V2 T2, V1 is V, and V2 is 2V, T1 and T2 are equal. So we can find out T2, T2 is your, T1 is your 400, T2 is your 800. Okay, so now we have to find out the magnitude of boiler. Okay, and in constant pressure, so using first law of thermodynamics, that is Q is equal to W plus W. So in constant pressure process, the as constant pressure process is there, so Q is your Cp T1 minus T2, and value is your Cv T2 minus Cv T1 minus T2, and T1 and T2 are known, and Cp and Cv are also known. Cp minus Cv is your R, R is 27. Okay, so put in the value of T1, T2, and Cp minus Cv, that is R, we can get W. Okay, so that is 114 is the